Hi everyone, Alejandro here with Ata Robotics. And in this video, we're gonna go over the latest firmware and app updates for your Evo 2 series. Welcome to the flight deck. In the latest firmware and app versions, we did introduce a few new features. The first one is gonna be our brand new panorama feature. Panorama mode is an automatic shooting mode in which we'll be able to get landscape, portrait, wide angle, and sphere panoramas in real time. To access panorama mode, you'll tap the intelligent flight mode option in the top left-hand corner of your camera view. You'll now be presented with the four different panorama options at the bottom. Prior to starting the panorama, you can tap the small white arrow in the bottom right-hand corner. Then you can adjust your camera settings, so you can adjust between auto and manual exposure, as well as changing the format of your picture from JPEG to RAW, or both. Please remember that even if you're shooting in RAW, your final stitch panorama will come out in JPEG. Getting into the four panorama modes, first we have landscape, which is your typical panorama mode from left to right. So the Evo 2 will take 12 images and then stitch them together. Next, we have our portrait, which takes 9 images from top to bottom, which gives you a vertical panorama. Then we have your wide angle panorama, which will take 11 images corner to corner. And lastly, we have the spherical panorama, which gives you as close to a 360-degree view as possible by taking 26 images. With the sphere option, because of the processing time, you will have to stitch that in post-production. Once you've selected your panorama option down at the bottom, you can tap the red go button on the right-hand side. The Evo 2 will automatically now capture all of the images by tilting the correct camera angle as well as the heading of the drone itself. Once it's captured all of the images required, it will begin processing the panorama itself. Please keep in mind that while your Evo 2 is stitching the panorama together, you will lose image transmission, but you will have full flight control. Moving on to our next added feature in the firmware update is the customizable home point option. This is going to be great for anybody that after takeoff already knows a predetermined location that they're going to need to land at in case of an emergency. In order to access your customizable home point option, head over to the settings menu and the camera view, and then tap the general tab at the very bottom. At the top of the general settings menu, you'll see home point, and then you'll see three different options. You'll see me, aircraft, and then customizable. Once you tap the customizable setting, you'll be taken to the map view in your Autel Explorer app. You'll now have a couple of different ways to set that customizable home point. Up at the very top, you have a search bar where you can search for a location, such as a city or an address. You can actually tap anywhere on the map, and the small H will now be where the home point is. Or the third option down at the bottom is setting the home point via the longitude and latitude GPS coordinates of the location. To confirm that the custom home point has been set, go ahead and tap back into the map view and ensure that that H symbol is located wherever you need it to be. Always remember to verify that that custom home point has been set and that you're setting the custom home point after you've already taken off. Now moving on to Photo Auto Sync, which is a brand new camera setting that allows users to automatically synchronize any still images taken on the Evo 2 to their phone's gallery app. Please keep in mind that this feature is currently only available on the iOS version of the Autel Explorer app and will come to the Android version in a later update. You can find the Photo Auto Sync setting down in your advanced camera settings. When you bring up your exposure settings, in the bottom right-hand corner, there will be a small camera icon. You'll tap on that, and then you'll slide down about halfway and you'll turn on the Photo Auto Sync. The next new feature in this firmware update is the added addition of the speed mode change using the customizable buttons on the back of your remote controller. You'll now be able to quickly switch between the standard and ludicrous speed modes by just tapping and holding either the A or B button on the back of your RC. You will now be able to go into the settings menu under remote control, and you can now switch between standard and ludicrous mode with the A and B buttons. Just as a reminder, if you do switch into ludicrous mode, your obstacle avoidance sensors will turn off. The next optimization that we made in the firmware update is with our gimbal pitch. The first thing that we optimized was your gimbal pitch sensitivity. Under the gimbal settings in your Autel Explorer app, that gimbal pitch sensitivity now defaults to a value of 90. Meaning that now if you move it down to, let's say, an increment of 1, you'll actually only move 1 gimbal degree for every 10 seconds. So you have much more capability of playing with that gimbal sensitivity to get the right shot that you want. You'll also notice that we've optimized the overall gimbal movement. We've added a more gradual start and stop sequence when using the gimbal scroll wheel that's on the left-hand side of the remote controller. All of these gimbal improvements will lead to much smoother shots for all of our professional users. Also introduced a pre-recording function for your Evo 2 aircraft. This will allow your Evo 2 to record a short clip of up to 60 seconds of image transmission prior to you hitting that record button. This new feature can be found in your advanced camera settings, which can be activated by going to your exposure settings, tapping on the small camera icon, and then scrolling down to the 30-second pre-record option. This will automatically sync to your device's gallery app, but please keep in mind that this function is only currently available on the iOS version of the Autel Explorer app. Lastly, for our users in the US, Japan, Australia, and in the Greater China area, we did introduce a compulsory no-fly zone database update. This update is based off of your drone's GPS location and not your mobile device location. Unless you're a user that's in a country that requires that we restrict you in a no-fly zone, you will only see notifications in your local airspace. You will not be restricted from taking off. Once you're on the latest app and firmware versions and you have an internet connection, the update to the no-fly zone database will automatically be downloaded from your Explorer app up to your aircraft. Please allow 2 to 3 additional minutes once the prompt on your Explorer app disappears for the update to finish. We will be consistently updating the no-fly zone database, but if you don't see any notification in your no-fly zone, don't worry, it most likely is coming soon. Just make sure to always abide by your local regulations. As a reminder, Autel Robotics does not collect any personal information from our users, and this update will only be prompted by your drone's geolocation. That's it for this app and firmware update. Thanks so much for watching. Go ahead and give us a like on the video, subscribe to the channel, and don't forget to comment down below and let us know what video you want to see next.